So class 9, yesterday we have studied about the topic Reach for the Top, and in that we have started with Santosh Yadav. Okay, so Santosh Yadav, who was, where she was born? She was born in Haryana. Which district she was born in? Rewari district of Haryana. Okay, what was the name of her village? Jonewas. Okay, she was born there, and what kind of atmosphere she had in her family? What kind of atmosphere? Conservative family. Okay, they were affluent landowners. Yes, she was following the traditional norms of the family also, where the birth of the boy is considered to be auspicious. But she was one of the blessed child in the family, as she was the only daughter in the family after 5 sons. So she was most welcomed by her parents as well as her grandparents, right? And why she studied in the village school only? Because it was accustomed, or it was the tradition of the family, that the children should study in the village school only, right? So then afterwards, when she first rebelled or presented her desire at the age of 16, she first of all presented her desire. What kind of desire she presented? That she didn't want to marry. How she was different from the other girls of her society or of her locality?
Because other girls used to wear traditional dresses,
and she preferred to wear shorts. Okay. And how we can say that she was determined, or she has complete trust in her thinking or in her feeling? If she will take any path, okay, she
knew that if she had
chosen a path, right? Not she. Okay, the others had to change, not her. Not her, sorry. Okay, right? So this we have read about Santosh Yadav. So next, let us start. Okay, so let us start with para number 4. Okay, so in para number 3, we have studied that she belonged to the family of affluent landowners, where the birth of the girl child, not although it is not considered to be auspicious, okay, but she presented her desire to rebel, or she wanted to live a life of her own when she has turned out to be 16 years of age, right? So a marriage as early as that was the last thing in her, on her mind. See here, remember this, see the preposition used here, it's not in, it's on. Okay, so sometimes in case of preposition, some exceptions are there. Okay, by reading you will get to know, right? Otherwise, this year this topic of preposition is not in syllabus, otherwise it is there. Okay, so to get married was the last thing that was on her mind. She threatened her parents that she would never marry if she did not get a proper education. So she, first of all, she presented her desire in a cool manner, or in a very, you can say, understanding manner. But when her parents, they did not listen to her, and they were forcing her to get married. So she threatened her parents, okay, that if she would not get proper education, she would never marry in her life. See, she, being a girl, she knew the importance of education. Otherwise, bachche to bhagte hai na padhai se. But she said, no, I want education. If I will be provided proper education, only then I will get married. She left home and got herself enrolled in a school in Delhi. See her, you can say, firmness in her decision. Okay, it means from this, we have also come to know she is resilient towards her goals, towards her thinking. Okay, note down that she was resilient. Adamant also, we can say, what is the meaning of adamant? Stubborn, determined. Okay, she was adamant also. Okay, have complete trust in her thinking. Have complete trust in her thinking also, right? So what she did when she got to know that her parents were not ready to provide her proper education, what she did, she left her home and herself got enrolled in one of the school in Delhi. Means she did not have any money. She started to do a part-time job in order to pay for the fee, right? And when her parents refused to pay for her education, she politely informed them of her plans to earn money by working part-time to pay her own school fees. So when her parents, they denied that if you will get education in Delhi, we are not going to pay your fee. So what she said, okay, it's fine. Don't pay my fee. I will do a part-time job and earn my school fees. So this is again a setback for the parents. So her parents then, they agreed to pay for her education. Okay, so finally they did not have any other choice. So they agreed to pay for her education. Now, wishing always to study a bit more and with her father slowly getting used to her urge for more education. So naturally, by the time what has happened that in the family, father and mother who were thinking or who were trying to impose their wishes upon her, slowly and gradually they have also come to know now she won't listen to us. Okay, they also get accustomed to this that she is always wanting study and good education. And they knew that she wanted and she will definitely do it. Santosh passed the high school examinations and went to Jaipur. So what she did? She passed her high school examination and where she has gone to? Jaipur. Okay. So after completing her schooling in Delhi, where she has gone? She has gone to Jaipur. This is the great, you can say, changing phase in her life. This going to Jaipur, it has provided a new, you can say, a new opportunity to her life. And let us see what she has done. So she joined Maharani College and got a room in Kasturba Hostel. So underline it. So where she has got enrolled in Jaipur, where she has got admission, she has got admission in Maharani College. Okay. And where she was living, where was her accommodation? Kasturba Hostel. Okay. Santosh remembers Kasturba Hostel. It faced the Aravali Hills. I used to watch villagers from my room going up the hill and suddenly vanishing after a while. So what she has studied, what she has observed. So her hostel room, it was facing the window. From the window, far you can say, in the far sighted area, there were mountains. And daily she used to look at many people, they are going up the hill. She thought that they were village people. Okay. So, and suddenly vanishing after a while. Then she has also noticed that these people, they vanish after some time. Because it was a great height. Okay. So naturally there were some bushes, some trees behind which they vanished. Okay. So one day I decided to check it out myself. So she was inquisitive, wanted to know where they are going, why they are going there. She was inquisitive to know that. She was curious to know that. Okay. So what she did, she decided to go herself and check what they are doing there. Right. So she went there. I found nobody except a few mountaineers. And to her surprise, when she has gone there, she has found that they were not actually village people. Who were they? They were the mountaineers who were climbing those mountains. I asked, I could join them. So she asked them, can I join you? And to my pleasant surprise, they answered in the affirmative. Affirmative means positive response they have given and motivated me to take to climbing. And what they said? And they said, yes, you can join us for climbing and you can be a part of our expedition. Okay. So this is how she has started mountaineering. Right. So it was the turning point in her life towards mountaineering. Yes. When she has gone to Jaipur. Okay. And what was the curious thing that she has noticed there? The villagers were climbing up the mountains, right? Okay, they were climbing up the mountains. But actually, they were villagers? No. They were mountaineers. So what, when she has seen the mountaineers there, so what spirit she has felt within? She thought to join them. Okay, she thought to join them, right? So next. Then there was no looking back for this determined young girl. So this was the turning point. And after that, she has never turned back. Okay, she was moving forward in that direction also. She saved money and enrolled in a course at Uttarakashi's Nehru Institute of Mountaineering. See her determination. See her firmness in her thoughts. She saved money herself. And later on, she got admission in Uttarakashi's Nehru Institute of Mountaineering. Please underline it. So where she has got admission? In Uttarakashi's Nehru Institute of Mountaineering. My college semester in Jaipur was to end in April, but it ended out on the 19th of May. And I was supposed to be in Uttarakashi on 21st. So I did not go back home. Instead, I headed straight for the training. Okay. See her determination. See her dedication towards her purpose, towards her goals. It means that she was dedicated also. Right. She has the quality of perseverance also. Right. Hardworking also. So see, she said that my college semester, that her exams in college in Jaipur, they are going to end in April. But because of some reason, they ended on 19th of May. And her training at Uttarakashi, it will start on 21st. Just one day was there and half day of 19 she had. Okay. So what she did, she said that I did not go back to my house to meet my parents. Okay. But where she has gone? She has gone directly to Uttarakashi's Institute of Training. And I had to write a letter of apology. Apology means to feel sorry, to cut a sorry figure. To my father, without whose permission I had got myself enrolled at Uttarakashi. So what she did, she said that then afterwards I had to write a letter to my father in which I have explained what I have explained, that I have got enrolled in Uttarakashi Institute. It means that she is not even telling her parents about her plans. But later on, she is delivering all the facts to them. Next. Thereafter, Santosh went on an expedition every year. Her climbing skills matured rapidly. Okay. So then afterwards, she has found a way. Okay. Now she is following that way. And now what happened, that she went on an expedition. Expedition means adventurous trip. Okay, every year she is going for some kind of expedition. And because you know that slowly and steadily we learn by our experiences. Okay, so what she did, her this climbing skills, they matured rapidly. So rapidly she has learned everything. Okay, also she developed a remarkable resistance to cold and the altitude. So she was strong enough. Okay. She has developed resistance to that of cold climate also, right? Because the climate was too cold. So she has developed a resistance also to that and higher altitude. What is the problem in higher altitudes? As we go higher, okay, the temperature is lower down and air is also depleted. Okay, there is also depletion of air and it is difficulty to breathe there. Okay, so but she has tamed her body according to the changing climate. Okay, because on and off she is going. For the first time, if you are doing a task, it is difficult. Next time it will be a bit easier. So slowly and gradually, what is happening, it is coming out to be easier for her. So equipped with an iron will. So this is, underline this. So what kind of quality she also has? Iron will. Okay. Strong will, firm determination. Okay. Equipped with an iron will, physical endurance. endurance means tolerance power. Okay, physically she was strong enough and an amazing mental toughness. So these are the qualities. Okay, mentally she was tough also. Mentally tough means determined, right? Firm in her decisions. And mental toughness. She proved herself repeatedly. So what are the qualities which helped her to prove herself? Her iron will, her physical endurance, as well as her mental toughness. So these were quite helpful in showing her ability to achieve. Okay, right? So next, she proved herself repeatedly. The culmination means end point, terminating point. Okay, the culmination of her hard work and sincerity came in 1992. So the top point of her endurance or her firmness, when it was displayed, in the year 1992. Just 4 years after she had shyly asked the Aravali mountaineers if she could join them. Again, she wanted to go, okay, on an expedition, but she was not sure whether they would allow her to go or to join her because she's quite young in her age as well as in her experience too. So what she said, she asked them, okay, that in 1992, she wanted to join those mountaineers at barely 20 years of age. Santosh Yadav scaled Mount Everest, becoming the youngest woman in the world to achieve the feat. Feat means? The task of bravery. Okay, so what she did, that finally what happened, that only at the age of 20 years, she is the one who has scaled Mount Everest. When she has scaled Mount Everest? At the age of 20 years. In which year she has scaled Mount Everest? 1992. She has scaled Mount Everest in 1992. Okay. So, if I'll ask you, after completing her education in Delhi, where she got admission afterwards? She got it, okay, Maharani College in Jaipur. So, where she was living there? What developed a spark in her? The sight of the mountaineers climbing Aravali Hills, right? Okay. Then, afterwards, after completing her graduation, what she did? Yes, she enrolled herself in Uttarakashi Institute of Nehru Institute of Mountaineering. Okay. So, what are the great qualities that were presented by her? Her iron will, her toughness, and physical endurance. Okay. So, what great feat she has achieved? Merely at the age of 20 years. So this is the great thing that she has achieved. Okay. Next. At barely 20 years of age, Santosh Yadav scaled Mount Everest, becoming the youngest woman in the world to achieve the feat. If her climbing skills, physical fitness, and mental strength impressed her seniors, her concern for others and desire to work together with them found her a special place in the hearts of her fellow climbers. It means that she is again good, not only good at, you can say, her physical display of qualities, but also her mind and heart was also great. Okay. She was very eager to help her fellow climbers. She is never stepping back to help them, and she is not showing any selfish motive there. Okay. And moreover, she is always admired for her climbing skills by her seniors, okay, by the physical fitness. Okay, one of the main reason of her physical fitness was her background also, as she is from Haryanvi background, and there, you know, it mostly belonged to the family of farmers. Okay, So healthy diet is one of the main reason, and this is the reason why most of the players, they are from Haryana. This you people very well know. Okay, so physical fitness and mental strength, that she is determined also, these are the qualities which are one of the reason for being appreciated by her seniors. So what are the reasons why she is always being appreciated by her seniors? And mental strength. Okay, these are the reasons of her admiration by her seniors. And why she is always being loved by her fellow climbers? Because of her concern as well as will to help others. Okay, this is the reason why she is always helping them. So during the 1992 Everest mission, Santosh Yadav provided special care to a climber who lay dying at the South Col. She was unfortunately unsuccessful in saving him. So it was just because of her disquality that she tried, okay, that she tried to save the life of a fellow climber, but it was, you can say, it was utter disappointment that she was not successful in doing so. And what she did in order to help him? By sharing her oxygen cylinder. She was unfortunately unsuccessful in saving him. However, she managed to save another climber, Mohan Singh, who would have met with the same fate had she not shared her oxygen with him. So next is that, but she has not stepped back afterwards. Okay, so another climber whose life she has saved was Mohan Singh. Okay, so how she has saved his life?
By sharing
her oxygen with him. Okay, so from here we come to know that she was always extending a helpful hand towards the fellow climbers. Right, this is clear. Okay, so within 12 months, Santosh found herself a member of an Indianapolis women's expedition that invited her to join them. So within 12 months after completing this, means within a year, 12 months makes a year. Okay, within those 12 months, she has found herself a member of Indianapolis women's expedition. Okay, and they have invited her to join them. She then scaled the Everest a second time, thus setting a record as the only woman to have scaled the Everest twice. Great. Okay, this is again great. Okay, that she has scaled Mount Everest twice. So what are the two different points when she has scaled Mount Everest? First time she has gone with the mountaineers who were climbing Aravalli Hills, and the second time she has joined Indianapolis women's expedition, who have invited her to join them. Okay, then this is the second time that she was able to scale Mount Everest. Okay, and securing for herself and India a unique place in the annals of mountaineering. Annals means in the fields of, okay, in the annals of mountaineering, in the field of mountaineering, she has secured a special place for her, which is always remarkable, which is always admired for, as well as appreciated by others. So what are the two great achievements of Santosh Yadav? And she has also no, that she has scaled Mount Everest twice, first with the Aravalli Hills, and she is the only woman who has scale Mount Everest twice. Okay, second time with whom she has gone? With the Indianapolis women's expedition. Indianapolis women's expedition, she has gone there. In recognition of her achievements, the Indian government bestowed upon her one of the nation's top honors, the Padma Shri. Underline it. Okay, so in order to recognize her great achievement, she is conferred with a great award, which is named as Padma Shri. Now, describing her feelings when she was literally on top of the world, she said, it took some time for the enormity of the moment to sink in. Enormity means greatness. Okay. So when she was asked what kind of feelings you were filled in when you had reached to the top, when you had climbed the summit, when you have reached the summit of the mountain. So what she said, for some time, I was unable to adapt the reality of the situation. I was unable to understand the enormity, greatness of the situation, that really it has happened, that had I really scaled Mount Everest, and then I unfurled the Indian tricolor and held it aloft on the roof of the world. So what she did, she unfurled the Indian flag, and then she unfurled it, and she felt great at heart also. The feeling is indescribable. She said that I'm not able to describe this feeling in words. So the Indian flag was flying on top of the world, and it was truly a spiritual moment. Spiritual moment filled of satisfaction, contentment. When you have deep satisfaction inside, deep inside your heart. Happiness is something different, but spiritual happiness is something different. When you don't have any ill will with the world, when you don't have any grudges with anybody, when you are quite calm in your mind, this is called spiritually, means you are satisfied. Okay, so at that time, what happened, that she has felt spiritual moment. It was spiritual moment, and I felt proud as an Indian. So she felt quite proud as an Indian. So also a fervent environmentalist. So this is another quality. Fervent environmentalist. What is the meaning of fervent? Concerned. Okay. Concerned. You can also say having sincere feelings towards environment. She collected and brought down 500 kilograms of garbage from the Himalayas. Okay. So being an environmentalist, what she has done, she has collected 500 kilograms of garbage from the Himalayas. Okay. So that's all for the chapter that we have read. And tomorrow we will continue with the question answers also. And now if you have any doubt, you can ask me.